Let me start by asking you a question. If someone is a victim of a severe car accident, what organs do you think are the most vulnerable to traumatic injury and why? I think that since you are watching this video, you won't be able to answer this question now, because you need to know about body cavities first. However, I intentionally started by asking this question so that while you're watching this video, you find the answer by yourself. First, let's define body cavities. They are spaces within the body that protect, separate, and support internal organs. We can see some body cavities in this image. We have some others also. In this video, we will go over each one of them. We will start with the dorsal body cavities, which are the cranial cavity and the vertebral cavity. The cranial cavity houses the brain. It is formed by cranial bones. The vertebral cavity or the spinal cavity houses the spinal cord and is formed by the vertebral column. Then we have the thoracic cavity or the chest cavity. It contains the pleural and the pericardial cavities and the mediastinum. As written in this table, each pleural cavity surrounds a lung. The pericardial cavity surrounds the heart, and the mediastinum is the space between both lungs in the central portion of the thoracic cavity. Now, if you didn't understand where the mediastinum is, it is the part highlighted in green. It extends from the sternum to the vertebral column and from the first rib to the diaphragm. It contains all the structures of the thoracic cavity other than the lungs, like the heart, the trachea, the esophagus, the thymus, and large blood vessels. Now for the abdominopelvic cavity, it is subdivided into two cavities. The abdominal cavity that contains the stomach, spleen, liver, gallbladder, small intestine, and a large portion of the large intestine, and the pelvic cavity that houses the urinary bladder, portion of the large intestine, and internal organs of reproduction. Now we have some other body cavities, like for example, the oral cavity or the mouth that houses the tongue and the teeth, the nasal cavity that houses the nose, and the orbital cavities that house eyeballs. Also, we have the middle ear cavities that are small bones in the middle ear. And finally, the synovial cavities. A synovial cavity is a joint cavity found in between the segments of the bone and the articular cartilage. The synovial fluid is located within a joint cavity of a synovial joint. Now back to our question. The organs that are the most vulnerable to traumatic injury are those found in the abdominal cavity, because as we noticed, they are not reinforced by bones like the other body cavities. For example, the ribs protect the thoracic cavity. However, the abdominal cavity is only protected by muscles. This was everything concerning body cavities for this video. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you have any question, just leave it in the comments.